Hi, Sunil ji. Good afternoon. How are you, sir?
Good afternoon. I'm fine. Thank you.
Sir, thank you for your time. Sir, you know, markets are seeing a lot of volatility. What is your outlook on it?
I think commodities have been trading in a very tight range, especially the precious metal segment. If we talk about gold and silver, you know, gold is kind of maintaining the range of $1,700 to $1,740. In this tight range, it is trading currently. We are seeing gold is hovering around $1,730 mark, and in the domestic market, the prices are hovering around 44,900 levels. Even though the market has opened positive today by 150 points, but it is not, you know, holding these levels because every now and then we are seeing the prices again going down to 44,500 mark. If we see the dollar index is trading close to 92, it is exactly trading at 91.85 at the moment. But in between, we have seen a range of 91.20 and 92.50 as a range. So it is trading close to 91.85, which means it is maintaining some strength. And that strength in dollar index is kind of putting pressure on gold. And that's why domestic prices are also below 45,000 mark. Going forward, I believe the strength in dollar index will further put pressure on the gold prices. And the short-term range, what we expect is it to touch $1,700 to $1,680 mark. So another $30 to $50 correction is what we are anticipating before we see a strong pullback again. I mean, the target that we discussed, $1,680 or $1,690 from current level of $1,730, is a very short-term target that we are expecting. Maybe by this weekend, we may see those levels touching. And maybe in the domestic prices range of 44,000 can be seen, which is 900 rupees lesser than what it is trading today. But if you ask from a 3 months or 6 months perspective whether that looks to be a good range to enter, I believe yes, 44,000 mark in the domestic market, it is a decent entry for somebody who has 3 to 6 months time horizon from gold perspective, and we may again see the prices touching close to 49,000 or 48,000 in 3 to 4 months time. In the dollar term also, we may again expect a pullback once it touches 1690. We may see a pullback again towards 1800 to $1,830 mark, because over a period of time, as Fed has also communicated to the world that they are not in a hurry to increase the interest rates. And they are also urging the banks to keep the inflation close to 2%. And these things are anyhow going to help, you know, gold prices go up as the dollar will continue its weakening process as we move ahead. Plus, Joe Biden's $1.9 trillion stimulus measure will also support the weakening of dollar, and obviously it should help gold prices go up as we look from 3 to 4 months perspective. Silver, on the other hand, it has not corrected as much as gold has corrected. If we see, silver is still trading close to 67,500 mark, which is just 11,000 rupees less than the all-time high, wherein gold has fallen by 12,000 rupees from its recent high. That means a correction of 11,000 rupees a kg for silver versus 12,000 rupees correction for gold 10 gram. You know, we can say confidently that silver has not fallen as much as the gold has fallen. So from that perspective, silver is drawing demand from, you know, the overall industrial demand, which is picking up. The better data is also suggesting some positivity there. Even the base metals had, you know, picked up in the recent past, and even that has suggested. So over a period of time, we'll see some demand coming in from the green energy sector for silver, also the electric vehicle segment. And even the demands from the overall electronic gadget industry is going to drive silver prices up. So I believe that, you know, the withdrawal of safe haven appeal from gold has pushed the prices down with the improving bond yields or strengthening of the dollar in the short term. For silver, that hasn't been a case because 60% or 70% of the demand for silver comes from the industrial side. And with better hopes of speedy recovery of the economy, with the kind of vaccination distribution happening, with positive data coming in from US as well as from China, with stimulus measures supporting the inflation going up, silver prices are expected to outperform gold prices as we move ahead. So next 3 months time, I think silver will be more aggressive in terms of price appreciation than gold. And we may anticipate a target of again 80,000 rupees a kg kind of in the domestic market. So all in all, we expect a buy and dip strategy should work well for both gold and silver. 44,000 range for buying for gold, and 67,000 is the current price for silver. Any range between 66 and 67,000 looks to be a decent buying point for gold and silver.
Right, sir. So what about crude and natural gas?
Okay, crude oil has been actually range bound again. We have recently witnessed a surge in crude oil prices. WTI is trading close to 66 and Brent is trading close to $70 mark. So there are a couple of things that one needs to consider. One is that OPEC plus nations decided not to increase the supply. They have kept the supply intact. In fact, some of the countries have extended the production cut in the next month as well. So the extension of production cut to April has in a way supported the crude oil prices. All in all, if we see US crude inventories are also, in a way, if we see last 5 years average, they are increasing gradually. So that is not allowing the prices to go up beyond $70 mark, at least from the WTI crude is concerned. So from overall price perspective, OPEC plus decision to keep the supply steady, and Saudi Arabia's voluntary cut of 1 million barrel per day into April, held the prices close to $66 for WTI, and even Brent prices were kind of held close to $69-$70 mark. Do we see the price rise from here? Is it a good level to buy again? I believe the prices have already discounted the fundamentals, so we expect the prices to probably come back to $62 mark from WTI crude perspective. So that means another $4 correction is what we are anticipating. Why we are expecting a small correction in crude oil prices? Because US inventories on one side, we can see the supply is building up. 13.8 million barrel worth of supply is what they're holding at the moment. And even crude oil inventories over a period of time, if we consider, U.S. crude inventories have gone up by 6% if we compare it with last 5 years average, which means U.S. supply is going to possibly put pressure on this. And as and when we see crude prices going above $65 mark, even the shale oil production comes into the picture. So even that will ease out some supply concerns that we currently see from the OPEC side. To an extent, the market will have supply from shale as well. So these fundamentals are going to put brakes on the crude oil prices going up beyond these levels. So over a period of time, I think even the US Texas cold weather impact on the output also is also kind of easing out. So even that is kind of anticipated that it may put pressure on the crude oil prices as we move ahead. In the very short term, I believe one can sell crude oil in the domestic market around 4,800 range, which is the current price. We can target 4,600 rupees in the domestic market. That means a correction of 200 rupees is what we can expect per barrel. And one can possibly put a stop loss of 4,900 rupees in the domestic market. And whether 4,600 is a good entry level for buying as such, if you ask me, I believe it will maintain a range of 4,500 and 4,900. It will move in this 4 to 500 rupees range in the coming 2 to 3 months' time. So I believe at the moment, since it is trading close to 4,800, looks like a good strategy to sell, targeting 4,600 rupees, backed by the increase in U.S. inventories at the moment. And I think even the Texas cold weather impact is also kind of withdrawn. So even that may ease out the supply there. On the natural gas front, I think overall the inventories have been decent. And decent inventory and even better than normal weather is kind of impacting the natural gas prices. Currently, the price is trading below 200 mark. The April contract for natural gas is trading at 189, which is down by 5 rupees today. And that is backed by improvement in the overall natural gas inventory there, plus the improvement in weather. So the main purpose of natural gas is to use it towards heating purpose in the extreme cold weathers in the US. And with the ease in US weather, I think the demand for natural gas to an extent has come down. Plus the improvement in inventories is also kind of putting pressure on the prices. Whether the prices will continue its slide towards 170, I don't think so. Maybe 188 is the current price. We may see another 8-9 rupees correction. 180 looks to be a decent buying range again, because we may again see some pullback in the prices towards 200. So 180 range can be looked at to buy. 170 can be a stop loss, and again one can target 200 rupees. So buying dips for natural gas is something which we can recommend.
Right. So what about the metal space?
I think base metals have witnessed some correction. If we talk about copper or zinc or lead or nickel or aluminium, they have come down a bit in the recent time. The major reason why the base metal prices are correcting, at least from the copper perspective, if we start with, one is the policy tightening in China ahead of parliamentary session is kind of putting pressure on copper prices. We are expecting some tightening in policies towards the overall projects that were underway, and that should impact the demand for copper. And secondly, even the US Treasury yields improvement is putting pressure on the prices. And thirdly, I think even some technical profit booking was on the cards, because it was trading close to a decade high levels, and some profit booking was also anticipated. On the higher side, we have seen copper touch 737 rupee a kg in the domestic market, which currently trading close to 678. Even some profit booking was one of the reason why it had come down. But overall, if we see, it has again come back to a level where somebody can think of buying here. We can again see a price of 700 to 710 coming in, because the long-term fundamental looks positive. Because overall production for copper this year has been down. Year on year, if we compare, the overall Peru mining production was down by 12.5%. So the demand from China, demand from the electric vehicle segment, this year we are anticipating the demand will outpace the supply, and that should support the prices. Since the prices have already corrected, we may see some buying coming from here. In the domestic market, we recommend a buy around 675 level. One can keep a stop loss of 665, and one can again target 700 and then 710 in copper. And on the nickel front, it is currently trading at 1163. With one more large mine getting back to its normal production, the prices corrected drastically from Russian point of view. The nickel producing mine was active again, which was kind of locked for water concerned issues. But with the increase in supply, we saw a huge correction in nickel prices, but the prices have bottomed out again. They are trading close to 1163 now, and looks like we may again see a price of 1200 rupees. So one can buy around 1150 range. When we talk about nickel, we can put a stop loss of 1130, and a target of 1200 can be looked at from nickel perspective.
Right, sir. Sir, thank you so much for your time. Always a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you very much for having me on the show. Thank you.